So dear students, in today's class, I'm going to discuss about 7 5-year plan in India. So in the last class, we had discussed about the 6 5-year plan in Indian economy. And from that class, we come to know that 6 5-year plan was one of the successful plan in Indian planning history. So today we are going to focus on 7 5-year plan in India. So the basic thrust area of this plan was to enhance social justice through supply of some new or improvement in the sector like education, in the sector like health, and some other family welfare measures have been given more emphasis during this plan. Using of modern technology in agriculture sector and some new anti-poverty schemes and the issue of food security was also there in the 7 5-year plan. So during this plan, the basic or the ultimate goal though was to generate inclusiveness in Indian economy. However, the word of inclusiveness were not documented. Was not documented directly. However, from these or from different areas of importance, we came to know that inclusiveness was one of the hidden agenda of 7 5-year plan in India. During this plan, the Prime Minister of India was Rajiv Gandhi, and the Deputy Chairman of Planning Commission was Manmohan Singh. So let's see what were the objective of 7 5-year plan. So there are so many objectives. I'm just trying to highlight some of the key objectives of 7 5-year plan. So the first objective is that the 7 5-year plan was tried to keep the same momentum of growth that was achieved in the 6 5-year plan. And at the same time, it tried to reduce poverty or remove poverty, and removal of poverty was one of the key agenda of development during 7 5-year plan. So the first objective was to maintain the momentum of growth in the economy while redoubling efforts to remove poverty. So redoubling effort means, so Indian government had developed different strategies so that the poverty can be removed or can be reduced from the economy. And the second objective was that economic growth must be accompanied by social justice and by the removal of age-old social barriers that oppress the weak. So we know that sometimes what happened in an economy, the economic growth rate may be good. In recent times, what we came to note, in most of the countries of the world, the growth rate is tremendous. However, the issue of social justice will be there because sometimes what happened, the government failed to allocate the resources in a proper way. So that is why there's lack of social justice. In the case of Human Development Index, that types of country cannot improve themselves because of improper allocation of resources. That is why one of the key issues or key objective of 7 5-year plan, economic growth as well as to achieve social justice. And the next objective is implication of more intensive agricultural development and the severity of the balance of payment constraint require that continued fast agricultural growth and self-sufficiency in food must remain a top priority. That means in this objective, the 7 5-year plan, through this objective, the 7 5-year plan try to improve the productivity of agricultural sector by imposing some new modern technology in the agricultural sector, like implication of more chemical fertilizers, improve irrigation facilities, mechanization of agriculture. These strategies were implemented at that time so that the productivity of Indian agriculture will be improved. So intensive mode of agriculture is nothing but the implication of some modern technologies so that the productivity of agriculture can be ensured. And the second point is that to maintain a very good balance of payment or to reduce the constraint in the balance of payment, agricultural growth was given more emphasis. And the self-sufficiency of food was also one of the key issues of the 7th Five-Year Plan. So these are the intensive mode of agriculture reduction or to improve the balance of payment constraint through agricultural development and food security were the objective of 7th Five-Year Plan. And the next is that at the time, the rate of population growth was very high. And the sectors like social sectors development were not so well sound at the time. So that is why the 7th Five-Year Plan had given emphasis on family planning. At the same time, it has given emphasis in education, in healthcare facilities like that, so that the status of women will be improved in the economy. They will get some social respect. So they will get some economic respect too. So girls' education were given more emphasis at that time to have some improvement in the status of women in the economy. And second, another objective is that at the time, there is energy shortages in the Indian economy, and there was energy shortages. And that is why the 7th Five-Year Plan had given attention to upgrade the energy sector in the economy. And the another objective, the plan expected the labor force will grow at the rate or grow by 39 million people, and employment was expected to grow at the rate of 4% per year. That means to generate employment opportunities, the 7th Five-Year Plan had given emphasis or to achieve some good employment opportunities or to generate some good employment opportunities was one of the objectives of 7th Five-Year Plan. And the efficiency, modernization, and competition in industry was also there. Integration of science and technology in the mainstream of development planning was also one of the good objective of 7th Five-Year Plan. Let's see what the outlay of 7th Five-Year Plan. The total outlay that was decided initially in 7th Five-Year Plan was 180,000 crores, but it was revised and the actual expenditure was rupees 218,730 crore. And highest priority sectors were the sectors like agriculture, or the sectors like energy and power, 30% of total outlay were invested to upgrade the energy and power sector. Social service and education were also given more emphasis. Communication and transportation was also one of the key sectors to be developed by the 7th Five-Year Plan, and the outlay were distributed accordingly. And I have shared the sector-wise development of outlay in this slide. So next, what were the achievements and failures of 7th Five-Year Plan? The 7th Five-Year Plan, which came to close in March 31st, 1990, is estimated to have achieved a growth rate of 6% per annum as against the targeted growth rate of 5%. So we can say that the 7th Five-Year Plan able to achieve the growth rate that was targeted, and it is greater than the targeted growth rate, and that is why we can term this plan also as one of the successful plan in Indian planning history. However, the expenditure incurred during the plan period far exceeded the plan expenditure, but it can achieve or it achieved the targeted growth rate more than the targeted growth rate. And another achievement
some of the shortages, some of the failures, or some of the shortcomings in the agriculture sector was also there. Though there is some intensive mode of agriculture during 7-5 years plan, but the food grain production was not achieved the targeted one. The targeted food grain production was 180 million tons per year. However, food grains produced only 172 million tons, and 8 million tons was a little short of target set. So, however, taking all the sectors into consideration, there was an increase of 3.23% of terms of productivity during the 7th 5-year plan. So productivity was improved during 7th 5-year. We cannot deny this. That's productivity of all the sectors were improved at the time. Social injustice was reduced. So proper distribution of education facilities, proper distribution of health facilities, or some family welfare measures were there. So that is why the 7-5-year plan were able to reduce the social injustice in the economy. And service sector were also performance sector was also performed well during this plan, and it was growing at the rate of 4% per year. And manufacturing sector also performed well during this plan. Special programs like Johar Rozgar Yojana were introduced. The plan gave large outlays to welfare, education, health, population control, and job opportunity creation. So we can say that the 7-5-year plan able to get the hidden agenda of the inclusiveness in the economy with the improvement of education sector, with the improvement of the health sector, population control, and job opportunity creation at that time. So we can term this plan as one of the successful plan in Indian planning history, and the growth rate was very handsome at the time because it was greater than the targeted growth rate. So if you have any questions, any doubts, any suggestions regarding this class, you can put in the comment box so that I can improve in the coming days of my classes. Hope it will be helpful for the coming examinations like APSC, like UPSC, NET, SET, etc. So your cooperation is very important regarding the content of the class. If you have any suggestions regarding this class, then I'll be a happier person. Thank you. If you give some suggestions so that I can also improve my classes. Thank you.